now, when we understand that Shiva is the first thing that is established in the matter, then in us also first the Shiva is established. When the fetus takes its form, the throb in the heart is the establishment of Shiva. That is the sign that Shiva has been established. In case of people who are born with bad heart or with trouble, one has to say the Shiva is not fully established. Not that they are bad people, but they are not supposed to live for long and have to have another heart later on maybe, or that there might be some sort of a problem in their previous lives, and if they pay attention to Shiva Tattva, their heart can be cured. So the most important organ in the body is the heart. If the heart fails, you cannot remain. So the most important thing is to look after your Shiva principle, which is the earth. We are worried about every sort of mundane thing. Worried about this, worried about that. But we are not worried about our spirit. This is the biggest problem with us. If you worry about your spirit, if you pay attention to your spirit, the whole universe then vibrates with Parabrahma, which is nothing but joy. So without any attention to spirit, if you think we can enjoy life, you cannot. You cannot enjoy your life if you pay attention to other nonsensical things and you do not pay attention to your spirit. The complete silence comes into us only through spirit. If a spirit is awakened within us, this silence starts working and you feel extremely relaxed and absolutely one with yourself. There is no problem. You don't see other things that normally people see. You seek your own company and you want to be sometime with yourself. Only thing that you seek after finding your spirit is the company of other Sahaja Yogis who also have found the spirit. So there's a rapport established between spirit that is in the heart. And this spirit is the universal being within us, about which I have told you, that once you become one with the spirit, you automatically become universally conscious. There are so many qualities of the Shiva Tattva, of the principle of Shiva, that I need not tell you. But today I will tell you another dimension which I have not touched so far about Shiva Tattva. The physical aspect of Shiva Tattva is that such a person is more a cold type of a person. In the sense that such a person is not a person who brings hot vibrations, but who has too much of it sometimes, not in balance, who overdoes it, develops a kind of a temperament which can be extremely cold. Could be low blood pressure with it, could be diarrhea also. Diarrhea also one can get with too much of spiritual strength. And also could be on the plump side because of the left side. Because left side is the kapha, as you call it. Kapha is the phlegm that is more. Because the left side is more, such a person is always apt to catch cold and has problems of the course. So such a person has to protect oneself from getting into colds and things like that. And the methods to be employed are to be learned to serve yoga. But to give it a balance, the spirit itself is beyond health problems. But the left-sided person who always thinks of the spirit also can become one-sided when he has to live on this earth. He has to be a balanced person. So he has to take to another side, and that side is the activity of the spiritual growth within himself. A person who is very spiritually developed cannot exist as a Shiva Tattva on this earth. He has to exist as a balanced personality. And when he starts developing that balancing within himself, the spirit from his heart starts rising and goes on top of his head. So this is the second stage where one has to be. Here is the whole collectivity. So when you start taking your love and affection into your central nervous system, you can say, and put it on top of your head. That means as soon as you put it in your Virat, when it starts spreading through your Virata Shakti, through your collective being, then only you are a complete person. Otherwise you are Shiva Tattva. Shiva Tattva exists whether this universe exists or not. It exists even when the whole universe is existing, even when it vanishes, it all goes into that, merges into that universe. So a person who has a spiritual hankering must know that to raise your Shiva above the heart level, he has to raise it gradually onto a very detached method of existing on top of the surface, where there is a complete balance, complete balance. We all can change and inform each other and improve and educate us. All this education can come to us if we really love ourselves and care for our evolution. We don't have to bother about it much if we really care. Gradually all these things will work out and the balance can be established. Those people who talk too much should not talk so much. What I feel that when you talk too much, when you stop it, just stop. In between, when it is necessary, you must talk. When it is not necessary, you should not talk. So that kind of personality, gradually you can develop in Sahaja Yoga. That you will develop that wisdom, how far to go, how far not to go. Not to go is the quality of Shiva. He doesn't do anything. He's just sitting down there and watching the whole show. He doesn't do anything. But still, he is the one who has to watch. If he doesn't watch, then the whole show is over. If you understand that in not doing anything, how much he is doing? See the contrast. He is doing nothing as such, but he is making everybody dance to please him. In the same way, in one shot, you have both the nature. As Sahaja Yogi, you can achieve that kind of a balance. It is for your good, for your evolution, for your development. So today, all of you have a great chance of evolving individually within yourself this Shiva Tattva, which ultimately permeates into the whole. Kabira has said it in a beautiful couplet. I don't know if you people have understood. It is, Mana Mamata Ko Thira Kar Launga. The compassion of my heart, I will vibrate. I will bring it out. The compassion of my heart, I will vibrate. I bring it out of pancho tattva milao and put it into the five elements. See Kabira ji, you follow him, how great he is. People talk of Kabira. See, he says that take it out of the heart and put it into all the five elements. This is what is sahaja. If you understand that, then you don't have to understand anything. You have got it in your heart, become the capitalist in your heart and become a communist outside. If you can achieve this balance properly, you have done it. And we can do it. We all of us put together, we will do it, we can achieve. And we can show to the world that everyone can achieve. All ordinary human beings, so-called, we can become extraordinary. So today we have to decide about ourselves that we are going to do it, we are going to be educated about it in a spiritual way, in a sahaja way. And every moment, if you watch yourself, you can. And not to explain yourself, or to say, oh, this happens to me and that happens to me. That's not the point. Many people tell me like that. That's absurd. You challenge yourself, how can it happen to you? Why don't you do it? You should do it. Why can't you do it? Like that, you take yourself to task and you can work it out, I'm sure, because you have got the power. I bless you all for your spiritual development and for your collectivity. Both things must be looked at. If you have spiritual development and no collectivity, it is useless. If you have collectivity and spiritual development, none, it is useless. Combine it properly. So we have to take Shiva and establish him into the Virat. This is what we have to do. And if you understand this point, your relationships with others also will be good, permanent, of a very substantial nature. And the quality of Sahaja Yogi's life will be something very, very great. May God bless you.